revelation of God's power and the reality of God, and he didn't wait for an invitation. He said, "What must I do to be saved?" That's the only way that could happen is God works in the heart. The Spirit of God. And so we're going to be amazed in eternity when we realize how many things have happened in people's lives that you have never seen. People here could testify. You remember times when God dealt with you, God talked to you, you became aware of something, and it was real to you. Sanctifying work of the Spirit and to be raised in the faith. Now, I'm going to back up here. I'm going to come back. I'm going to go back to the beginning of 1 Thessalonians. I'm going to point out some things about these people that kind of go along with what he says there. Verse 4, he talks about, he uses some of the same language here. He talks about how he came. He says, "For we know, brothers, loved by God, that he has chosen you." Gospel came to you not simply with words, but also with power, with the Holy Spirit, and with deep conviction. Now, conviction, think about what a conviction is. A conviction is something that I know deep down. And I'll tell you, when God begins to convict, when God begins to come and convict the human heart, your mind and your emotions many times will rise up in protest. Because what he shows you about yourself is something you do not want to see. But what he's talking about here is a conviction and knowledge of your true condition that only God can put there. It has nothing. It bypasses your intellect, it bypasses your fear and your emotions. It's there, and you have hearing it. It is a